Okay, with new video. Today I'm gonna show you how to make up your our QR code actually with AI, using AI. The workflow I will describe is my own method. You may also see different workflows on the internet, but I have seen that the method I will describe gives good results. And I use the Stable Diffusion, obviously, and I will use the Stable Diffusion also web UI. You can download it from the automatic 1111 GitHub repo, and you can run it from it. And also I'm going to use ControlNet with this method. So also you can download it from Stable Diffusion web UI extensions tab, which is named SD web UI control net. You can download it from available and load from, and then you need to click load from, then you have to find the name here, and then you can download from here. So when you download the ControlNet extension, you need to restart your web UI. So when you restart your web UI, you will see the ControlNet section here. So if when you open this section, you have to see these tabs here. If you don't see these tabs, you should go to settings and you should find the ControlNet, and you can change this line and apply the settings, and you need to restart again your web UI, and most probably you will see these tabs here. So because we need to use these tabs. So we will not generate QR codes on AI, so we need to use existing QR codes, or we need to generate new one. So I'm using that page generating QR codes because it's free and you don't need to account, and also the web's page allows us to change the error correction level of the QR code. So we should use the highest level of the error correction level. So, and I'm using 250 pixels, it's enough. When you generate your QR code, you can download it from here. So, yes, let's start how we can make up our QR code. So I mentioned before, so actually I'm using Dream Shaper 6 for a main model, as a main model, sorry. Then you can download it from Dream Shaper Hugging Face webpage, and also you can download ControlNet models from the Hugging Face ControlNet page. So today I'm using one of standard ControlNet model, which is Tile. You can download it from here. And also I'm using a non-standard ControlNet model, which is named Brightness. You can download it from here. So I will share also these links on the description area. And yes. So when you generate your QR codes, so you have to use two tabs. We are going to use actually two tabs today with this workflow. So we should choose our QR code for this tab, and also we should choose same QR code for second tab. So we should enable it. And we should choose InPaint Global Harmonious, so as a preprocessor, and brightness as a model. So, and then I will going to change control weight to 35. I am not going to change anything, starting control step and ending control step. We can keep it as it is. So when we, and on the second tab, we should select same preprocessor, but we should choose the different model tile in the second tab. So in the second tab also we will change the control weight 65 and starting control step to 35 and also end control step to 75. So we don't have to change anything instead of this. So we can keep it crop and resize and control mode as balanced. So another thing, I'm going to change sampling method to DPM plus 2M Keras because it is, which is the fastest sampling method. And, but you can use also Euler A. So I'm going to use text to image, not the image to image. So we need a prompt also. So I'm going to use this prompt. I copied from internet actually, it's not my own prompt. So this is the prompt and also negative prompt. And so I need to check again. So we selected model and set first up brightness and tile. So everything seems okay. So DPM, okay. So dream shaper, everything is okay. So yes, only we have to do, just click the generate button to make up our, forward the make up our QR code. So this machine is MacBook Pro i9, which is not powerful for these things, generating images with AI, but it can do so, but it takes time. So I will fast forward this part actually of the video because it takes time also. So everything is okay. So yeah, we can click the generate button. Here is the result, and as you can see, so it's great, isn't it? So this is a good example of how AI can easily change ordinary things in our lives, business or something. So maybe you can use for just fun, but yeah, this is the good example. So it's completed, then you can change your prompt and for different results. So I hope you enjoy it with this video. See you in the next video. Don't forget, if you like it, and please follow me if you like it also.